I think an awful lot of people have wasted time and money doing weedings that haven't really helped them, because they haven't gone to the principle of what are we trying to do when we're weeding. I'm Klaas Martens. Our farm is in near Penn, New York. We've been organic since the early 1990s, and we farm about just under 2,000 acres. So we have a lot of tools that work for blind cultivation, and there are more all the time. So the purpose of the blind cultivation, and then the early post, where we're still using the same type of tool but going over a crop that's emerged, is to try to get the maximum weed crop size differential that we can. Then when we come in to row cultivate, we've got the ability to throw some dirt under the plant or up against the plant to bury the weeds that are in the row. If the crop is the same height as the weeds, the best we can hope for is to take a strip of weeds out between each row. We end up with these rows that are, I wouldn't say half crop and half weeds. They can sometimes be 3/4 weeds and 1/4 crop, but you can't bury them if they're the same height as the crop. So that's why it's really important to do the blind cultivation. A new tool that has come up that is somewhere in between and has been really useful is the finger weeder. Finger weeder is plastic stars that come together, and each of the plastic stars has steel fingers under it that are a smaller diameter. So the steel fingers engaging the ground are setting the speed that the wheel turns at. That makes the plastic fingers, which are longer, travel a little faster than your ground speed. And if that finger weeder is over a row, the fingers are coming together, they're plucking the weeds out of the row and depositing them between the rows. They've got different diameters, different compounds of plastic, different hardnesses for different crops. And this thing really works, but it has to have loose soil. So for a finger weeder to work, you have to have a cultivator or something ahead of it that's loosening the soil if the ground is hard. There are several companies now selling this combination where they have a European weeder that's shank, has a sweep that's toward the row, it undercuts, and it loosens the soil, breaks the crust so that the finger weeders can actively work in the row. And they can be used at the same stage where the second tine cultivation or blind cultivation would come, and effectively pull all the little weeds out of the row, but also control the weeds between the rows. The caveat with this tool is that if you can't drive perfectly, it's going to do an awful lot of crop damage and miss a lot of weeds. Except there's another piece of technology that's suddenly available, and that's the camera guidance. These cameras are accurate at, believe it or not, faster than you can drive a tractor. So these things all make it possible to get away, either have bad weather or get away with doing some things that you shouldn't have done, and still end up with a clean field. We have a 12-row system of these still. If you want perfectly clean fields, like what we've been able to get, you have to have the cultural practices right, you have to do some of the blind cultivation, and then you have to do a good job with your tool. It's fatal to take one high-tech tool, no matter how good it is, and use it as a substitute for the whole package, the whole management package.